Facebook, with a growing frenzy about the company's plans to finally go public to sell shares. Reports say the paperwork for an initial public stock offering could be filed in the next few days, a deal worth billions.
Twitter Incorporated plans to make its IPO filing public this week.
Companies like Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube are worth billions of dollars. How do they get started? Well, it doesn't actually take a genius to build a website. In fact, you can get started with just the structure of your website in a matter of minutes. Here's how. First, pick out a name for your site. Ideally, this should be something unique, not too long, creative, and easy to remember. You have your name picked out? Great, let's check its availability at instantdomainsearch.com. Is it available? Great. If not, try something else. Now it's time to go ahead and pick out a company that you're gonna register your name with. There's a ton of domain name registrars out there. And ultimately, it comes down to price. That's the main thing you wanna look for. I like name.com because it's easy to use for the checkout process, and they're affordable for .com domain names. You can also use a company like GoDaddy or even Google Domains. They sell them too. It's also a really good idea to check a website like RetailMeNot. It's a coupon website where you can find deals on your domains. Why not save some money while you're at it, right? Okay, let's go register that domain name. So head over to your registrar's website. In this case, I'll be using name.com and type in the domain name you wish to purchase. Now it's going to verify that the domain in fact is available. If not, it'll give you some few alternatives. Go ahead and hit continue to check out. Now, a lot of times companies will try and automatically opt you into add-ons and sign you up for multiple years. GoDaddy. Make sure you do not fall for any of their tricks. However, do keep Whois enabled. You want that. Why? Without Whois protection, people can see your name, your email, your phone number, and your address, so you probably don't want that information public. So, I always recommend Whois protection. This is also where you normally would put any coupon code you might have. Hit next step. Now we just need to enter our payment information, agree to the terms and conditions, and hit complete order. So now we have our name. Now we need to get some hosting because we need a place to actually host our physical website. I'm going to be using HostGator, but you can use whoever you want. I'm going to hit the Get Started Now button, choose a plan, one domain should be fine, and fill out the form. Once again, be careful not to buy any add-ons and look for coupons. Also note, some hosting companies advertise one monthly price and charge more after the initial billing cycle. Now let's check our email to make sure we got a welcome email. This could take a couple moments. We want to look for the name servers. If you do not know what your name servers are, simply Google your hosting company name followed by name servers. A lot of times, web hosting companies have help pages where you can find this information. Go back over your domain registrar and hit account. You should see a list of your domains. Click on the domain you wish to edit. Now you're going to have to look around the page to where you set the name servers. For me, I just hit edit name servers. You want to replace any existing name servers with whatever your hosting company provided you. Make sure you hit save or apply changes. Okay, cool. Let's go back to our email and look for our hosting panel login details. A lot of companies use a company called cPanel. You can totally forget about your domain registrar for now. You actually manage your site through your hosting account. Log into your website dashboard, then click on your file manager. I'm already where I store my website files. If you aren't there, go to public_HTML or htdocs. This varies by company to company. From here, you can go ahead and install WordPress. If you don't know how to do that, you can click the video over here. Or you can go ahead and code a website from scratch. Simply just make it index.html file, this is the default web page, and go ahead and start coding. I'm gonna pick the second option and just put in some basic code. I'm gonna go ahead and create a new file, call index.html, hit edit, paste in some code, and hit save. There you go, your website's live. You should be good to go now. Have a burning question on web development or something techie in general? Make sure to leave those in the comments section below or tweet them to me at TechTube Network or at Nels on Twitter. I'll make sure to answer them, and who knows, your question could be answered in a future TechTube Central video. Confused and need me to slow down? That's okay, you can head over to this video on Microtech Tutorials and see a full in-depth tutorial. I'm waiting. Anyways, guys, I'm Nels. Thanks so much for watching. Until next time, I hope you have a wonderful day.